I've been getting this question so much, I had to make a video about it. What do you do if you have ammonia in your tank? Maybe you didn't know about the cycling process and you just threw your fish right in the tank and now you got ammonia in there and it's killing them. Whatever the reason might be, you've got an ammonia spike and I'm gonna show you the quick and easy fix. Let's go. Welcome to Caveman Aquatics, guys. My name is Kev from CavemanAquatics.com. Here you're gonna find a bunch of helpful videos on all topics of the aquarium hobby that get straight to the point so you can get back to enjoying your fish. So if you're new to the hobby or would like to expand your knowledge on the hobby, this is the channel for you. Consider subscribing and you won't miss any new content. And make sure that you like the video if you found it helpful. So there are plenty of reasons why you could have ammonia in your tank, but that's not what you came here for. Like I said, straight to the point. First, I'm gonna tell you what to do right now to fix your problem, and if you're interested in the why, I'll cover that later on in the video. So the first thing you wanna do is a 50 to 80% water change. This is gonna get a big chunk of the ammonia right out of your tank. The reason why I say 50 to 80 is because only you know your fish. If you've got hardy fish and you've been doing big water changes and you think they can handle an 80% water change, go ahead and do an 80% water change. I do an 80% water change every week. If you're not sure what your fish can handle or you got a brand new tank, then go ahead and do a 50% water change. Now let's go over this step by step. Step number one is gonna be remove the water. Then you're gonna add Seachem Prime. Prime is going to detoxify the ammonia that's still in your tank water. Keep in mind, this doesn't remove the ammonia. It only detoxifies the ammonia temporarily, making the water safe for your fish. That was step number two. Step number three is gonna be, go ahead and refill your tank. When refilling your tank, you must make sure that your new water temperature matches your old water temperature or you will shock your fish. This is something that should be done on every water change. After you've refilled your tank, the next step is gonna be add Seachem Stability. Stability is basically bacteria in a bottle and it's gonna help boost your cycle, helping to grow the bacteria that you need to convert the deadly ammonia into a less toxic form. You're gonna add Prime and Stability daily for 1 week or until your water tests come back with zero ammonia and zero nitrite. After 1 week, if you still have ammonia or nitrite in your tank, you're gonna repeat the whole process. You're gonna do a 50 or 80% water change. You're going to add Prime both to dechlorinate the new tap water and to detoxify the ammonia in your tank. Then you're gonna refill your tank and then you're gonna add Stability. Do this again until your water test comes out with zero ammonia and zero nitrite. Also, do not feed your fish for the first 5 to 7 days. Your fish are going to add ammonia into the tank every time they poop. And by you adding food, all you're doing is adding more ammonia to the tank. Following this procedure will allow your tank to cycle with the fishes in the tank and not do them any harm. It'll help get your tank in a livable state immediately and boost the time it takes to get your tank properly cycled. Not to mention, it's gonna save your fish's life. Now, for those of you that are interested in the why, here goes. But first, if you found this information helpful, make sure you hit that like button. It helps the video out a ton and gets it out to more people that need help just like you. The most common reason for having ammonia in your tank is because your tank isn't cycled. And if you don't know what I'm talking about when I say cycling your tank or making sure your tank is cycled, watch this video right here. It's a very simple to understand explanation of the nitrogen cycle. In short, if your tank isn't cycled, you won't have the necessary beneficial bacteria that you need to convert this deadly ammonia. Most newcomers into the hobby, they either neglect this important step or they just think it's aquarium foolishness. No judgment though, I was one of those guys too. So many fish die and aquariums fail because of this very reason. They even gave it a name. It's called new tank syndrome. But let's say you didn't start a new tank and you had your tank for a while, but all of a sudden you got an ammonia spike. Now that's a different story. Well, there could be multiple reasons for this also. Did you add a bunch of new fish all at the same time? Doing this can absolutely cause an ammonia spike. You see, the beneficial bacteria in your tank is only going to grow as much as it's needed, as much food or ammonia there is in your tank for them to survive. Let me try to explain with a little bit of algebra. I know I might lose a lot of people, but check it out. Let's say you got 10 fish and those 10 fish produce X amount of ammonia. Eventually, you will grow the same X amount of beneficial bacteria that are gonna feed on that ammonia and convert it. But if you add a bunch of fish all together at the same time, now all those fish are producing X plus 10 amount of ammonia. And the X amount of bacteria that's in your tank can't handle the plus 10. There's too much food and not enough mouths to eat it. So that plus 10 stays inside your tank and then you get ammonia spike. When you add more fish, therefore adding more ammonia to your tank, the beneficial bacteria need time to grow and catch up to this excess amount of ammonia. That way you won't get ammonia spikes. Another reason for an ammonia spike is your cleaning process. Did you do a big tank cleaning? Maybe clean your filters out, move the substrate around, remove a big piece of decor? If you clean your equipment too well with soap and water and other chemicals, you will definitely kill the beneficial bacteria. If you clean your equipment with tap water, the chlorine in your tap water is gonna kill your beneficial bacteria. If you use tap water to clean your biomedia, you probably killed most of your beneficial bacteria. Or maybe you have a hang-on back filter with those cartridges. You know, when you remove and replace those cartridges, every time you throw one away, you're throwing away the beneficial bacteria that was growing on that old cartridge. No bueno. If you disturb a lot of your substrate all at the same time, you can kill bacteria. If you remove a piece of decor that had a lot of bacteria living on it and you decided to clean it, you can kill a lot of bacteria. Moral of the story is, no matter what you do to your tank or to your filters, you should always try to preserve as much of that beneficial bacteria as possible. That is the key element in your tank that's going to help convert ammonia to nitrite to nitrate. Now, if you watch this video all the way to the end, I'm gonna assume that you're kind of a beginner. So make sure you watch this playlist right here that I put together specifically for you with a bunch of helpful content that'll get you going. But before you check that out, make sure you subscribe right here so you won't miss any new content. See y'all in the next one.